Welcome to Office Mechanics. Coming up on today's show, if you're used to be able to work from any device, really with protection anywhere, we're going to look at how we're evolving the story around information protection. Now, we're also going to look at some of the new vision items that we're producing as part of Office 365 and beyond in the Microsoft Cloud. I'm joined by Rudra Mitra. Welcome.
Great to be here, Jeremy.
So you run the Office 365 Information Protection team at Microsoft. How does your team think about this, and what approach are you actually taking with your team?
So we think about things in three ways. We think about being pervasive, which is always being there, present, protecting, and being compliant on the data. We think about being transparent, so we know what's going on with the data, both within the organizations that bet on Office 365, as well as being transparent to the organizations with what's going on in the cloud with their data, operationally, security-wise. And we think about being people-centric. So try not to make it as hard a line between IT and workers, but really involve workers with the policies and the security that IT is trying to put in place. So those are the three.
Okay, so let's start with the notion of pervasive. What are we doing there?
With the volume of data that we're dealing with, it's really hard to think about applying policy and security after the fact. You really want to get in and apply it when this data is being created, when it's in the ecosystem, so that you don't have to post-process it, so to speak. So what I have for you here is, we've had Compliance Center out for a little bit, but here you go in and you manage your compliance policies across 365, which means across email, across SharePoint, across your instant messaging from Link for Business, and applying to other services as they come online.
So that's our new Compliance Center. These are all brand new things that we can see here. And I know that even beyond that, we've done a lot with managing mail flow also on the advanced threat side of the house.
That's right. So one of the newest things that's going on right now is the fact that threats are much more targeted at people and they are much more targeted at organizations. And so instead of bulk spam and bulk mail, now you'll see threats that are very targeted and will detonate post-fact. You'll get a link, it'll pass your spam filters. But after it's done that, you'll then see a detonation of the payload or it'll go rogue after that. So let me show you some very new stuff that we've built for this called Advanced Threat Protection. Right, so here you're seeing me show you safe attachments and safe links. Here you go set up what you want to happen when a link comes in a mail or when an attachment comes in. And quickly, Jeremy, I'll show you the IW experience of this if we could switch to the iPad. So this is, think of this as the worker who's got the mail and you know the IT person set it up. Now I'm looking at a mail that was sent to me. Looks pretty innocuous. And think about this as being any device, Android, iPad, mail client. So I'm gonna click on the Bing link. Bing loads up, no problem, fast. But the next link I'm gonna click is something that came in through our spam filters that's looking just fine. I go ahead and click on it and the spammer went and changed it after the fact. We block you, any device, you see this warning error and you decide not to go through.
So even if I redirect that to a new forwarding URL later, we'll be able to protect the user from malicious content. But beyond all of that, we've also evolved the story, and we're continuing to evolve that even with some recent things around risk management, because it goes beyond just protecting the information, but also from a risk management perspective, organizational search, there's a lot that we're doing there as well to improve transparency, right?
That's right. So transparency is the second pillar of what we're doing. There's a lot going on here, but here's a very early look at, again, a new thing that we're building. So we call this Audit Activity, and what you're seeing here is I've done a search over the last 7 days, and in the bottom of the pane, it's a little bit small to see. Let me zoom this out. You can see what we're looking at is an activity feed, a trace of what happened within this organization. Who downloaded the file, who opened it, who opened the file, who logged in. You're seeing this from the clients. You're seeing this from different devices. And the point of this is now an IT administrator, a business decision maker can go look at this data to see what exactly is sort of happening. Again, transparency in action.
And the other cool thing with this is you can also use the APIs and tie into that information if you've got your own applications, whether the line of business or you're a third-party app developer. All of these things you can do to actually extend and use those APIs and that audit stream to surface that however you'd like to surface it.
That's exactly right. That's exactly right.
So it goes even beyond that. So we actually have a lot of updates and something brand new around organizational search to show as well.
That's right.
To really continue on transparency and what we're doing there.
That's right, Jeremy. So the next new thing, again, to show here is we've had e-discovery in email and in SharePoint for some time now. So I've done an e-discovery search. The new thing to show you here is if you look at this, let me again zoom in a little bit so you can see this better. You see that I've done a search here for Facebook and tweets. Okay. So this is data that is not naturally SharePoint data, OneDrive data, or email data. So what I'm showing for you here is we've brought in data from external sources,
wow,
if it's relevant to a company,
okay,
and we've parked it in the same sort of storage that we have for other stuff. And let me now show you the search that I've gone through and done for this. And you can see that the Facebook data is up on the screen where I've searched for Facebook and some other words. We found that data, we've stuffed it into a mailbox, we figured it out. So when I search for Facebook, I can actually see it's highlighted that I searched for that. So now external data sources are also showing up in 365.
So that's huge. That means when you think about the vision going forward, it's not just about the cloud of Office 365 or the Microsoft cloud. It's really reaching into other services and being able to pull relevant information for us.
So let me show you this tech that I talked about being integrated with 365. So here what I've done is I have integrated into the system here all of the Enron public files that were out there. That was about 30,000 documents. I've imported them in. I've run Equivio on this tech. And what you can see is it's telling me that to get to what I searched for, which was actually agreements and drafts, two keywords I look for, you would typically go do a lot of keyword searches and kind of hunt and peck through documents. Here, it's saying that if I can look at the first 20 documents, which the machine will suggest to me, I can go get about 80% accurate, 84.6% accuracy that I've found all the relevant documents for the two terms I was looking for, draft and agreement. But let's say I'm not satisfied with that. I want to go a little bit higher. I want to be not just 84% accurate. I want to go be 90% accurate. Well, what I can do is I can bump that up, and now I see that I have to review 25% of the documents to get that level of accuracy. So it's giving me a trade-off of time versus accuracy. And really, you can imagine this in the legal vertical, in the internal compliance vertical being very relevant, where you can now, and in case law, this is coming through now, which is you can say, is it practical for me to go through and review a whole bunch more documentation, or have I satisfied a sufficient and necessary need? That's a pretty powerful set of tech that built into 365, integrated into what you have today, you'll find you don't have to go do a bunch of other integration. You get this machine learning right out of the box.
So really, really cool stuff there. But I know that it actually goes beyond this into the user side, because we agree and we think that the user should be part of this, information protection story. Part of that is really empowering them and really educating them to be part of the equation. So what are we doing around that?
So Jeremy, we are working on a set of features here that I'm going to show you around mobile device management and DLP. And really the focus, as I was talking about, is to reduce the compliance and security tension with workers and really involve them and educate them in the process. So here I've, in the compliance center, gone into device management, again, integrated across the left side navigation. And here I'm going to go in and look at my list of managed devices. So typically with BYOD, you'd see some tension around, can I put corporate data on my personal device? And back to this iPad, if I could show you this. Here, when I open up my mail, you can see that I have two profiles. This is my kid's device and also happens to be the one that I send corporate data on. That might make IT naturally a little bit worried about where the data is going.
Right.
So now we've gone from where IT would scrub the device and remove all the data, which include personal data and maybe organizational data, to where I can now selectively wipe if I lose this device or there's a compromise. I can go back through the admin console that I was showing you earlier. And here I'm going to issue a selective wipe. And we'll see if this comes through. And we need to do this not only because of IT requirements. There are countries where there are legal needs. There is the rule of the current place where you have to say, I will remote wipe a device, but I'm not going to do that for your personal data. That's just not allowed. So you can see now, if we're still looking at the iPad, that the personal data is still there. So Asaf's kids who set up this iPad, you can see that photograph's still there, his personal mails are still there, but the corporate data profile that was there, that's gone. So that's super powerful, both for meeting compliance needs for certain countries, as well as IT feeling like they can protect the device without interfering with your personal data. Really
great.
Does a great job of that.
Great. Even beyond that, we're doing a lot in terms of preventing data loss. And that story continues to grow as well in terms of all the different things that we can do within Office 365 at the moment. And that will continue to get bigger and better, right?
That will. So we've had data loss prevention for a while in mail. Now we're extending that to the Word, Excel, and PowerPoint client. So that's brand new for Office 16. And at the same time, we're going to see that you'll find DLP show up in SharePoint, so your documents in SharePoint are protected, Exchange are protected, and all these other clients.
Very cool. So let's have a quick look at what that experience looks like.
So you can imagine that this is my personal document library. So notice as I blow this up that there are certain interesting icons that are now present. This is, again, very, very new. It's in private preview. You can see that these new icons that are marking these documents, DLP has gone through in SharePoint and said, there's a credit card number in this document. My IT admin set that up as policy that they did not want this type of document flowing through the organization. It sequestered it. It hasn't destroyed the data. It's kept it, but it has moved it. And if I click on this, you can see that I'll get a policy tip that says, I have shared outside the organization a restricted piece of data, which is a credit card. But let me show you one more thing here.
Okay.
So not only is this in SharePoint, as I talked about, I'm going to open that same document up, and it's an Excel file, so you'd expect it to open up in Excel. This is brand new, Excel 16. And you can see that I get the same policy that is applied to the data flowing down through the client, and it educates me, telling me that there is sensitive data. I should not have credit cards in this organizational document.
Very cool. So even the apps themselves, as people are authoring their spreadsheets to be able to see what's going on there and if they're entering credit card information. So we've seen quite a bit. We've seen all the things that we're doing around mobile device management, around protecting files really at the root, in data loss prevention, even some of the stuff around risk management and organizational search with the exciting new Equivio things, plus all the auditing controls that we have to track it all. Where is all this going?
We're going to think about unified compliance, unified policy along those three pillars applied to data, not only in 365, but across all kinds of other data that you can bring into the system. And then we're going to have you compliant and secure with the same policies across all of those.
Love it. So we have to think bigger than the Office 365 cloud and even the Microsoft cloud, because it's going to go to all the different services that you're using. And everywhere data goes, we want to be able to protect it. You know, that's about all the time we have for this show today. Of course, you can find information on the Office blogs as it's released. Thank you all for watching, and goodbye for now.
Thank you.